there was an Olympics for engineering, this would be it. We're just outside Los Angeles, California at the Hyperloop Pod Competition. Some of the brightest minds from around the world are here to impress this guy, Elon Musk. For the teams at the Hyperloop competition, Elon Musk is the man. He's the visionary behind the Hyperloop and the leader of some of the most innovative companies in existence. Tesla, SpaceX, and most recently, The Boring Company, which is anything but. Elon Musk's futuristic transportation system could change the way we travel. The Hyperloop intends to propel passengers through a low-pressure vacuum tube at speeds up to 700 miles per hour. So you'll be able to travel from San Francisco to Los Angeles in about 30 minutes, which is faster than a plane ride.
We're capable of doing this. This is not, you know, just a pipe dream, no pun intended.
Johnny is a member of Badger Loop, which is named after University of Wisconsin's mascot. The team was one of the youngest that competed in the first Hyperloop Pod competition. Elon Musk launched the competition to encourage citizen engineers and students to design and build their own prototype pods. So in 2016, hundreds of teams from universities and private institutions around the world submitted their pod designs. SpaceX selected 30 designs to be built and tested at the competition.
We proved ourselves during competition one that we could hang with these extremely impressive programs from around the world.
Well, I f***ing shook Elon Musk's hand. He sat in our f***ing pod. It's the best day of my life. Go Badger Loop!
Badger Loop had a goal of getting their pod into Hyperloop's 3/4-mile vacuum chamber test track.
There's a very rigorous series of tests that you need to pass before you can get into the full vacuum chamber, and we were extremely close on the last one, but some electrical issues kept us from getting in.
While the Badgers fell short, they did make an impression.
Our first innovation award goes to Badger Loop, University.
SpaceX gave their pod an innovation award, proving their design had potential. So, as all good underdog stories go, the team is back and they're looking for redemption.
We are getting that too this time. We're not taking no for an answer, and we got to make sure that we do everything we can now to prepare and to get into that too.
The rebooted Badgers are young, scrappy, and yes, hungry, in more ways than one. Johnny is the team's operations director, overseeing the team leads who are in charge of building the different parts of the pod.
Arjun is our braking lead, and he's in charge of a small team that's designing our brake system that's going to have the incredibly fun task of stopping within a matter of seconds and going, you know, well over 200 some miles per hour and not blowing up SpaceX's $12.5 million tube. So good luck with that, Arjun.
He knows how to do math.
Yes. Engineer.
Yeah.
Clay is new to the team this semester. He's our propulsion lead, and he took on this challenge knowing very little about thermodynamics.
Then there's Justin leading structural analysis, Nathan on composites, Max on batteries, Ryan is on controls, Vaughn is the electrical and software director, Ben is on stability, Chris is on structural design, and Zuff is the team's president. And that's not even all the team leads. There are about 30 people working to make this pod a success. Hyperloop pods for Competition 2 are designed with the same goal in mind, speed. In order for their pod to reach over 200 miles per hour in the low-pressure vacuum tube, the Badgers are going to need a powerful propulsion system.
So the system that we have for propulsion is a coal gas thruster, which employs basic jet propulsion principles by accelerating gas across a nozzle.
It works like this. Two high-pressure tanks filled with nitrogen gas empty about 90% of their mass over the course of 3 seconds. As the gas exits, it converts thermal and pressure energy into kinetic energy.
The challenge is who can go the fastest and still stop.
Arjun's team designed a primary and secondary braking system that will hopefully do just that. And then the Badger's electrical team created code that will enable the pod to operate autonomously in the tube. But the crazy thing is, after 7 months of nonstop work in Wisconsin, the team won't be able to fully test their pod until they get here, the SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, for the Hyperloop Pod Competition.
The week before competition weekend, we call it testing week. I believe there's around 60 or so tests that SpaceX has for us to pass to get into the tube.
After a week of pulling all-nighters at a local garage getting the pod competition ready, the team needs to wrap up because it's time to roll, literally. In the ultimate display of teamwork, the Badgers push their 500-pound pod half a mile down the street to the SpaceX campus to undergo the final round of tests. There are 24 teams competing this year, made up of members representing more than 30 different countries. And only the teams that pass all of SpaceX tests get approved to go in the low-pressure vacuum tube. But it's a race against the clock. Even if you pass all your tests, if you aren't one of the first to do so, there's a good chance you won't get into the tube. There just isn't enough time for all the teams to complete the final test, which is an open-air run.
Being a few minutes late to one thing can add, 4 or 5 hours of us getting kicked back in line and waiting for something.
And unfortunately, that's exactly what happened to the Badgers. A series of small technical setbacks meant that they missed their window of time. Of the 6 teams that completed open air runs, SpaceX chose 3 to race in the main event on competition day. Paradigm, Swissloop, and the returning speed champs, WARR from Germany. It was a bittersweet day for our team, but when WARR broke 200 miles per hour in the tube, the Badgers were there cheering them on. But it wasn't all over for the Badgers. SpaceX announced that it would give out 3 innovation awards this year, and winning one of them would give the team a slice of redemption.
For their propulsion system, which we hope to see next year in the Hyperloop competition, Badgerloop, the University of Wisconsin.
We were over the moon. I mean, everyone was hugging and celebrating, and it was the perfect ending of this trip. You don't really believe that you can be amongst this company and be doing these things until you find yourself here and you're like, wow, this is really happening.
And in the future, if the Hyperloop does revolutionize transportation around the world, the Badgers will always be able to say they helped make it possible. If you're into engineering, you should definitely check out our video about the modern megastructure guarding Chernobyl from nuclear fallout. Thanks for watching Seeker. Make sure to like and subscribe for new videos every day.